Name.
Life production.
Age.
33.
Occupation.
Firefighter. Parent.
Hometown.
Cleveland, Ohio.
Where do you live and work?
Washington, D.C.
Are you married?
I am not.
Do you have kids?
No.
Give me three of your hobbies.
Martial arts, music, drawing.
Get it?
Yeah.
Good.
Hey guys, so the rest of my video is going to be probably an A&W first. It's going to be a director commentary of the tryout video I was trying to make originally because of a number of factors, including the video specs that came out. I realized it wasn't going to be feasible after spending weeks getting footage with my buddies at the various gyms in the area. It's going to be kind of a tongue-in-cheek Ninja Quest thing where I'm trying to collect power from the various quote-unquote ninja temples of the Northeast region from the Guardians or the other A&W finalists that train and have gyms in the area. There was all kinds of stuff. There was going to be Indiana Jones map sequences and Japanese overdubs, but it didn't work out, but I still wanted to share it. Didn't want to throw it away. Alright, so the first Guardian in the Ninja Quest was supposed to be Louie Moso. There's Louie. As you know, he was a finalist in the Northeast region last year. Unfortunately, hurt his leg prior to Vegas and ended up having trouble at the Warped Wall. Great guy, give you the shirt off his back, trains like a madman. So his thing was he was going to teach me how to work with an injury, how to get through pain, and he was going to be the guardian of toughness. So there I was failing miserably. We had to focus on upper body exercises. There's a salmon ladder. Louis is a stuntman. And somewhere along the line, he learned some rigging techniques, and he actually made some of the best obstacles that I've seen. I mean, they're pretty fantastic. His salmon ladder was awesome. There's the swap salmon ladder. This was right around the time that Sasuke 28 was being broadcast in Japan, so we were all crazy about the new obstacles. And this was continuing the theme of me working through the injury with the crutches. This was actually the fourth day after one of his A&W Pro Tour events where we were coaching the kids up there and letting them run around on the obstacles as well as some teens and adults. So my hands were pretty beat. We had to do everything on pretty much one take. So the end of this was I was going back to face the nemesis that crushed me at the beginning. There were some other shots too, but so Louis taught me how to tough through an injury and ended up the warp wall there. That was his final test. Actually failed the warp wall my first year at A&W2, got through pretty fast. But that was the symbolic giving you the power gesture. Yes, I stole it from Lord of the Rings. Nothing wrong with that. A lot of us A&W dorks are fans of that too. So he's sending me on my way to another temple on the Ninja Quest, which was the Warrior Lab, Chris Wilczewski's gym in New Jersey by the Philadelphia metro area. And if Tempest is the Lamborghini of Ninja Training Grounds in Los Angeles, the Warrior Lab is the Gravedigger monster truck. Everything's heavy, everything's abrasive, everything hurts, which kind of goes along with Chris's training style, which is pretty awesome. It's where we had the A&W Fall and Summer Leagues. A lot of the top guys from the Northeast region train there. And the theme here was everyone in there kind of had the meathead mentality, so we had the homage to the first person video game there, using the meat to knock me out. You know, you're in danger as soon as you walk through the door. There's Chris, multiple time A&W finalist, along with Jamie Ron, aka Captain G4, NBC. Trained with these guys pretty much every Saturday, every other Saturday when I could. Actually like to really thank my girlfriend for putting up with all that me traveling around. Then you see the bacon roulette cylinder and pipe slider of doom. We actually went to the grocery store beforehand and picked up a whole bunch of meat for this ridiculous display. Meditating, learning the ways of the Warrior Lab, and getting some. Coast. So we had a different way of giving me the power there. Merry Fistmas, Turkey Leg, going to the next place. And it was going to be the last test, which was not actually in Georgia. It was on the Long Island Sound by Louis Gym after an event. Ryan Stratus, Strat, was going to be the final guardian. A good buddy of mine, multiple-time finalist. He was going to be the guardian of strength. He was supposed to have a heavy backpack that I was going to train with. National Guardsmen, we were playing up the drill sergeant theme there. Doing the push-ups with the heavy backpack. Some goofy stuff with the Karate Kid style training. Yagi. Then this is what the entire skit was based on, was the Apollo Creed Rocky Balboa Beach Run World Grab Fest. Strat's about the closest thing to a A&W BFF that I have. I mean, just suffice it to say, we share the same everything. It's kind of ridiculous. Again, Strat giving me the power on the beach. And then a staple of the Strat Bernardo Foundation is the dorky Dragon Ball Z chain dance, which Slash transferring the power into the shot. See you at the tryouts, hopefully, and see you in Vegas.